मानते हैं या हम भ्रष्टाचार के खिलाफ बात करेंगे? जब हमारा बैलेंस शीट बनता है, हमारे चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट भी कहते हैं कि हम टैक्स कहां बचाएं, क्या हम भ्रष्टाचार के खिलाफ बात करेंगे? हम हमारे बिजली का मीटर तेज चलता है तो तार फंसा के उसे धीरे करना चाहते हैं, क्या हम भ्रष्टाचार के खिलाफ बात करेंगे? हमारा पड़ोसी के दरवाजे में घंटी बजाए और बच्चा दरवाजा खोलने जाए और हम उसे कहें, हमारा पड़ोसी घंटी बजाए दरवाजे पे आए, हम हमारे बच्चों को कहते जाके कहते पापा घर पे नहीं है, क्या हम भ्रष्टाचार के खिलाफ बात करेंगे? 1/125 करोड़ हिंदुस्तान आप है, 1/125 करोड़ हिंदुस्तान मैं हूं। आप अपना भ्रष्टाचार समाप्त कीजिए, मैं अपना भ्रष्टाचार समाप्त करूंगा, मुल्क का भ्रष्टाचार तब कहीं जाके समाप्त होगा। पूरा वो आप लोग कर सकते हैं, फैसला आपको लेना है, आपको कौन रोक सकता है मुझे बताइए? आप तो बहता प्रवाह है, आप चाहे तो समय चक्र बदल दें, आप चाहे तो सूरज को इधर से उधर ले आए, आप चाहे तो आसमान चीर के रख दें, आप नदियों का रास्ता बदल सकते हैं, आप पहाड़ों के अंदर से पूरा एक प्रवाह निकाल सकते हैं, कौन रोक सकता है आपको? अच्छा करने से, सच्चा करने से कोई नहीं रोक सकता, वो भावना होनी चाहिए। Then, if you grow, the country will definitely grow. You have to do that. But we lose hopes. We give up. The problem is, we just give up. एक पति बहुत बीमार हुए, तो उनकी पत्नी उन्हें दिखाने के लिए लेके गई, तो उसको चेक किया डॉक्टर ने। We just give up. I'm just giving one example. How do we give up? एक डॉक्टर ने चेक किया, और चेक करने के बाद डॉक्टर ने पति को कहा आप थोड़ी देर बाहर बैठिए, बीवी को बुलाया और कहने लगे देखिए जी ये ठीक हो सकते हैं लेकिन इन्हें थोड़ी शांति की जरूरत है, आप बस इतना काम कीजिए कि इन्हें थोड़े दिन रेस्ट रहने दीजिए, टीवी थोड़ा कम देखिए, घर में शोर शराबा मत कीजिए, जैसा चाहे खाना बना के दीजिए और 8-6 महीने ऐसा करेंगे तो ठीक हो जाएंगे। बीवी बाहर आई, पति पूछा क्या हुआ, क्या बोला डॉक्टर साहब ने? बोला बचने की उम्मीद कम है। यू जस्ट गिव अप बिकॉज़ वी डोंट वांट टू डू इट। There's two things. One is in the life. One is we have to. One is we want to. Right? One is we want to do it. One is we have to do it. What happens? One day, boy was sleeping in the bed. His mummy ne jagaya. Utho utho. Hello. College jana. No. I don't want to go. No. You have to go. No. I don't want to go. No. You have to go. No, I don't want to go to college. Like I don't like teachers. I mean, teachers don't like me. Chaparasi doesn't like me. And student don't like me. So I don't want to go. So mother said, whether you want to go or not, but you have to go. But you are because you are a principal of the college. आपको क्या लगता है principal की माँ नहीं होती? What I'm trying to tell you is in life there are two things. So want to and have to. I didn't want to come today, Mr. Mishra, let me tell you very honestly. But I had to come because your director said you have to come. And I could not help it. Because she taught me how to lead in the life, what to do in the life. And I have yet to see, let me tell you very honestly, I'm not here to praise Dr. Swati Rega. I spoke what I wanted to speak, and I'm speaking what I want to speak. But I have yet to see a better human being than her. And I always wish that a person should be developed like her as she is. You would be successful in life, but no arrogance. You would be successful in life, no flaunting. You would be successful in the life, but no bragging. You would be successful in the life, but you don't have to talk about it. It has to be as simple as that. Dr. Mishra, once again, I congratulate for you to innovating this kind of the college where you are doing such great activities here, Ashish. You are taking very good care of the things here, and I wish that it grows with the time, it goes up. Again, I would tell you, my dear friends, that just have a dream in the life and try to fulfill it, right? Take a challenge in the morning and convert into the achievement by the evening. Every challenge which you convert into the achievement, that gives you a sleep which nobody can give you in this world. When you sleep with an achievement, that's such a sound sleep, right? When you sleep with a feeling, yes, I have done it, nobody can give you that sleep. No pill in the world has come up which can give you a better sleep than that. That feeling you have to create, and that feeling is not sold in the market. You have to create within. And for that, you have to feel it. Take a challenge in the morning and convert into the achievement by the evening. It could be any challenge, my dear friends. Challenges are not that you have to earn 1,000 crore in a day. Challenges are not that you have to sign a space shuttle. Challenges are not that you have to do something which nobody did before. Something which you could not do. And that's a challenge for you. Like, you get up daily. Like, you get up late in the morning, 9:30, 10, and then you just take a challenge. No, today I will get up at 6. And you do that. And say yourself, yes, I have done it. You will have a better sleep in the night. What I'm trying to tell you, my dear friends, achievement aisa nahi hota ki jise aasman nahi sambhal sake. Achievement aisa bhi nahi ho sakta ki aap usse jail mein dalke chalte bane. Achievement bahut subjective hota hai. Ho sakta hai Ambani sahab ke liye 1,000 crore rupees achievement nahi ho sakta hai. Kisi ek vyakti ke liye jo din ka 10 rupees kamata hai, uske liye 100 rupees achievement. Achievement ki paribhasha har aadmi khud karta hai. Achievement ki paribhasha har aadmi khud tay karta hai. आप अपने अपने सपनों की परिभाषा तय कीजिए, आप अपने अपने अचीवमेंट्स की परिभाषा तय कीजिए, आप अपने अपने ख्वाबों की परिभाषा तय कीजिए और उन्हें बदल दीजिए, कन्वर्ट कर दीजिए शाम तक एक अचीवमेंट में, फिर देखिए कि जिंदगी कैसे बदलती है. लास्ट वन ऑफ माय मोस्ट फेवरेट स्टोरीज व्हिच आई रोट टुडे एंड आई वुड एंड विद दैट. इफ यू हैव दैट फीलिंग ऑफ डूइंग समथिंग इन द लाइफ, इफ यू हैव द फीलिंग यस आई विल डू इट इन द लाइफ, देन यू डू इट. एंड व्हेन यू डू इट, नोबडी कैन गिव यू अ बेटर सेंस ऑफ अचीवमेंट देन दैट. Years back, I was a cultural ambassador from Rotary Foundation to a state in America called Arkansas. You must have heard the name Arkansas. And Arkansas state mein ek jagah thi Blytheville. Blytheville ke paas ek bahut choti jagah Hot Springs. Hot Springs mein main gaya, wahan maine ek tasveer dekhi. Wo tasveer main utha ke le aaya. Wo aaj tak mere office mein lagi hui hai. Us tasveer ko dekh ke maine ek kahani gadhi ki is tasveer mein jo do log hai unke beech mein baatcheet shayad ye hui hogi. वो तस्वीर थी जॉन एफ कैनेडी और एक 12 साल के स्काउट विलियम जेनिफर. 12 साल स्काउट आप समझते हैं, स्काउट वी हैव इन आवर स्कूल्स एंड कॉलेजेस एंड ऑल दैट. 12 साल का स्काउट और जॉन एफ कैनेडी. स्काउट इज शेकिंग हैंड विद द जॉन एफ कैनेडी, द प्रेसिडेंट देन. जॉन एफ कैनेडी इज वन ऑफ द मोस्ट पॉपुलर प्रेसिडेंट्स ऑफ यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स ऑफ अमेरिका. एंड एनीवेज इन एनी कंट्री इफ यू हैव अ चांस टू शेक हैंड्स विद द प्रेसिडेंट, It's a great moment for anybody, for the 12-year scout. Such a great moment. When I saw that picture, I brought it to my office and I thought for a longer time, and I thought that what would be the talk between, what would be the conversation between these two guys. And that guy was shaking hands with John F. Kennedy, so I thought this guy, and when John F. Kennedy must be shaking hands, John F. Kennedy asked a question to this guy, "My dear young man, how do you feel?" And he said, "Sir, I'm feeling as if current president of America is shaking hands with the future president of America." Yeah. And my dear friends, that William Jennifer Clinton became 2 times president of that country. Twice. He did it. The person who shook hands with Kennedy in 1961-62, he became a president of that country twice, and he made it a history. You can make it. Everybody of this world can make it. Your director who goes to Harvard, your director is known as one of the best management authors in this country and on the international circuit. Comes from a school, you would not believe it. A district called Barmer in Rajasthan. Very, very pristine rural area, and there is a school called Jalepa. There's 10th mein classes chalti. She studied whole life there. She married when she passed her first semester of MBA. And after marriage, she passed 3. You don't have to take any advice out of it. After that, she passed 3 semesters of MBA and she did it because she wanted to do it. Anybody who wants to do it can do it. You could do it one day. I see all the successful people sitting here. I don't see the present students. I see the future leaders. And you are the future leaders who will make and create the history of this country. You will change the fate of this country. And I want you to do that. Because you are the one who can change the fate of this country. Because I don't see this youth as perverted one. I don't see this youth jinki raah bhatak gayi hai. Main is youth ko puri urja aur energy ke punch ki tarah dekhta hu. Isliye kehta hu, kya kaha andhera jeet gaya aur kya kaha ujala haar gaya aur kya kaha suraj ke sare hi kunbe ko lakwa mar gaya. Nahi, ye jhoot baat hai, saazish hai, makkari hai, aur is peedhi ko awara kehna gustaakhi hai, gaddari hai. Ye peedhi sab kuch kar sakti hai aur yahi peedhi is mulk ka bhagya badlegi. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. It was indeed very inspiring, and you've actually generated a feeling of love and patriotism amongst all of us right now. Sir, you should come to our college often to make us laugh.
There's a special portrait made by specially able foot artist Mr. Nadeem from Mouth and Foot Painting Artist for Mr. Shailesh Lodha.
Give him a big hand. Stand up. You know what? Proud of you.
Very proud of you.
I mean, thank you, Nadeem. Thanks is a very small word, I would say. Nadeem ne, mere khayal se Khuda ne mujhe jitna khoobsurat nahi banaya, utna Nadeem ne khoobsurat bana diya. Aur ye ek aapke samne udaharan hai ki zindagi mein koi bhi badha sirf bahana hai. Chitrakari ungliyon ki karamat hai. खुदा ने जैसे उंगलियां नहीं बख्शी उसे ऐसा जहन बख्शा कि उसने इतना खूबसूरत चित्र बना दिया अपने पांव की उंगलियों से. क्या बात है नदीम, राइट? इसलिए आपके पास कोई साधन हो ना हो उससे कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ता. आपके पास इच्छा होनी चाहिए, जिसका अनुपम उदाहरण जो मैं अपने भाषण में कह रहा था नदीम ने आके इसे साबित कर दिया. दिल आंखें बंद करके भी वो चेहरा देख सकता है. वो तमाशा ही नहीं है मगर तमाशा देख सकता है. और हम खिड़कियां दरवाजे बंद कर ले तो भी क्या होगा, जो सूरज है उसे जमाना देख सकता है.
Also,
there's one more small gift.
Once again, let's have a huge round of applause for Mr. Shailesh Lodha. Our next speaker for today is Ms. Shweta Mangal. She is a social entrepreneur and co-founder and CEO of Zikitsa Healthcare Limited. Zikitsa Healthcare Limited operates more than 800 advanced and basic life support ambulances across India. Since its launch, the service has served over 2 million patients. She has received several prestigious awards like the Times of India Social Impact Award 2012, Godfrey Phillips Bravery Award from Honorable President of India, Pratibha Patil, and Special Recognition and Continuity and Recovery Initiative of the Year in Public Interest by BCI and Deloitte in 2008. She has given a new horizon to social entrepreneurship. What better way to learn more about social entrepreneurship and innovation than Ms. Shweta Mangal herself, who managed to innovate a simple idea and save lives of thousands of people. I now request Professor Diti Amburle to give a floral welcome to our guest, Ms. Shweta Mangal.
Thank
Also, I request Ms. Shweta Mangal to share her idea of innovation and social entrepreneurship on this special occasion.
Just be 10% what he was and tell you what we have done so far. So I'm Shweta Mangal, and I first like to thank Mr. Mishra and Dr. Swati Lodha for having me here. I met her at IIM Ahmedabad, where I was supposed to give a talk on women leadership, and she actually loved the presentation and she asked me to email the same presentation, which is on women leadership, but of course I'll talk about leadership in general and social entrepreneurship. So I'm Shweta Mangal. I'm not from Mumbai. I'm from Rajasthan, and I'd like to just start with telling you who I am, where I belong, and how this whole idea of ambulances actually came up. So I'm a Marwari girl, born in a very conservative Marwari family, wherein my mom got married when she was 16 years old. My mom was a very bright student, and she always kind of had that regret that she got married at a very early age, and she never got a chance to actually do what she wanted to do. So I think at a very young age, she decided that if she had women, and she had girl child, she would give them the best. And so the whole journey of two girls, which is me and my sister, started. We do have a younger brother. So at a very early young age, she taught us that we are not girls, we are boys, and we have complete freedom of choosing who we want to be and what we want to do. It was very difficult for her, believe me. She sent us to one of the best schools in India. I'm from Mayo College Girls School. Then I went to JMC, and then I got into this whole idea of going to the US to study. I just want to tell you a little bit, you know, it might sound a little boring, but you know, it wasn't easy for that woman to do what she did, because she actually had to sell her jewelry to make us study. Because my family was so conservative, they said that ladkiyon ki education pe itna paisa nahi kharch karna chahiye. So she actually paid the fees of the school and told my family that it's only this much, whereas it was much more. And she sold the jewelry to actually get us into the good schools in Ajmer. Anyways, you know, I was in college. I was fairly good as a student, you know, first division, things like that, not the topper. And, you know, this was 1994, I went to Delhi. And that time, if you all remember, the Mandal Commission was going on and reservation and things like that. And at that time, every young student hated India. We hated India because there was so much burning of students. We didn't understand that time, ki reservation kya hai, kyun hai. We used to only read in the papers and see on TV. And, you know, we had this group of people in JMC, which is Jesus Mary College, and all the girls, you know, we used to talk about how much we hate India. And I was one of them. And for me, that time, my dream was to get out of this country. I did not want to be a part of this country. I thought this country was useless. It didn't have anything to offer me as a person. And I took my GMAT, I went abroad to New York to get my MBA. Believe me, in the first week when I landed in New York, I hated America. I started to love India. But because I had fought so much to go to the US, I said it's my duty to finish my education, do some work, recover some of the money which my parents have spent, and then go back to India. Anyways, you know, I did my MBA. I worked in California for a couple of years. And, you know, this whole fight in my mind, whether I want to go back to India, whether I want to stay in America, was happening. I was 22, 23, you know, and I want to tell one thing to all the people here, that at 22, 23, you can be confused. It's not a crime, okay? A lot of people, a lot of parents expect their children to know exactly at the age of 15 what they want to do, I'm sorry. You know, we are young students, we don't know what we want to do, right? So at 22, I was very confused, and as usual, all the friends, family members who I spoke to, and I thought, and even discussed the thought of coming back to India, they said that I've gone mad. Because in 2000, if you all know, that it was really difficult to get a job in India. And there I was, again confused, and one fine day I was driving to work with all these thoughts in my mind, and I got into a major accident. That accident actually changed my life, because I thought to myself, if I had died today in America, I would have never returned to my country. I don't want this in my life. I took the next flight, I landed in Delhi, I told my mom I've come for a holiday, because I didn't have the guts to tell her that I've actually come back for good. So that's how the story began.